2018 at 7 a.m. The sky was drizzling and Mr. Singh was waiting for someone. He walked impatiently as the person he was waiting for never arrived. As he went through the property of the person, he noticed something strange. He quickly went over to the residence of the person, knocking on the door once, twice. Nobody answered. He wondered to himself, "That's unlikely." He pushed the handle of the door to find it open. As he entered the house, his gut feeling made him aware that something bad had happened. Making his way into the house, what he saw was unlike any scenario. The scene in front of his eyes shocked him completely for the coming years. It was the body of 11 people hanging next to each other like the branches of a banyan tree. This was the mystery of Burari deaths or the Chundawat family. Netflix has released a documentary recently called The House of Secrets, Burari Mystery. I watched the series and at the end of the video, I'll give a review of it. But first, to understand the series, we must understand the case the series is talking about. After the first responders arrived at the scene, the entire locality knew about the situation and a crowd gathered around the area. At 7:18 a.m., a call was made to the police control room. The constable that entered the house first and saw the bodies couldn't believe whether it was real or not. Rajiv Tomar was the first responder to enter the house. He recounts the incident as, "In my career of 17 years so far, I have never seen a crime scene like this, and I hope I do not ever have to. It was shocking. I stayed only for 15 to 16 seconds before rushing downstairs to call my seniors." On the first floor of the house, bodies of Bhavnesh Singh, Lalit Singh, Savita and Tina were found. Alongside the elders, the children, Neetu, Manika, Dushyant, Shivam, Pratibha, Priyanka were found hanging in a circular motion. The eldest, Narayani Devi, aged 77, was found dead. It was alleged that she was strangled. After the entire incident was laid out, there was two hypotheses in front of the police and the investigators. The first one was a mass murder. The deaths were suspected to be a case of murder because the bodies were found with blindfolds, their limbs were tied, their mouth was covered with cloth, and their ears were plugged with cotton. This led to the police believing that they were murdered by an outsider. However, as they scanned through the camera, this hypothesis was broken. No outsider was seen entering the house. However, a shocking revelation by the CCTV showed Tina Chundawat buying stools and wires which they used later for carrying the act, and alongside her, Shivam also accompanied her. This led to the theory of mass suicide. Mass suicide. The second hypothesis arose when police found the CCTV footage which showed Tina and a family member carrying stools and wires. As they were investigating the house, they found 11 diaries preserved by the members for around 11 years. The diary was written every day. It was almost as if the diary was dictating their life. Even small details such as behavioral changes in children, prayer times, and what food to consume were also mentioned in the diary. It was through the diary that the hypothesis of mass murder was confirmed. During the last entries of the registry, the entire process of mass suicide was mentioned word to word in an instructional language. It also mentioned the process for the eldest, Narayan Devi, to be conducted by laying on floor since she was old. However, the family did not expect to die. In the diary, it was mentioned that the ritual called Bhat Puja will take place for 15 minutes. After that, they will be released. However, the ritual went wrong, as we all know.
कि घर का हर एक सदस्य सुबह उठ के उन वो रजिस्टर जहाँ जिस जगह रजिस्टर रहता था वो रजिस्टर को चेक करता था कि आज का रूटीन क्या है हमारे लिए कौन क्या करेगा किससे क्या नाराजगी हो गई तुम्हें आज रात को ये पूजा करनी है, सुबह बेबे का ये काम है।
देयर इज अ डायरी एंट्री December 24th, 2017 वेयर इन इट्स रिटन ध्रुव का फोन पर बहुत ध्यान जा रहा है, उसका ध्यान रखो। सो इवन दीज काइंड ऑफ लिटिल थिंग्स दे हैव मेंशनड इन दोज डायरीज एंड द डायरीज एक्चुअली टेल देम हाउ टू कंडक्ट देयर लाइफ।
अजीब और गरीब बातें थी उसमें लिखी, वो किसी तंत्र मंत्र और तांत्रिक क्रिया की तरह पूजा पाठ से जुड़े हुए हो सकते हैं और ये उसी दिशा में ये मौत हुई है। ऐसा लग रहा था कि जैसे कोई तीसरी शक्ति इन लोगों के अलावा कोई और है जो लिख रहा है इन्हें डायरेक्शन।
आफ्टर द एंटायर केस वाज कवर्ड बाय द मीडिया एंड द पुलिस हैड स्टार्टेड वर्किंग ऑन द इन्वेस्टिगेशन, द मेन क्वेश्चन दैट बैफल्ड द एंटायर नेशन, द इन्वेस्टिगेटर्स एंड द रिलेटिव्स ऑफ द फैमिली वाज व्हाई? व्हाई डिड द फैमिली टेक सच एन एक्सट्रीम स्टेप? Because from people who viewed them from outside, they were a happy family with prosperity growing for them and more opportunities coming their way. Why did they take such an extreme measure? So to learn why did this happen, we will have to look into the history of the family. So let's look at that. The Chundawat family was originally from Haryana's Tohana village, and during the 1990s, Bhopal Singh alongside his wife Narayani Devi moved to Delhi. He bought a plot in Delhi's Burari area and he came to Delhi after selling his farmlands and cattle to his village friends. The eldest son of Bhopal Singh, Dinesh Singh, refused to move to Delhi because of his familial roots in Rajasthan. A regular and prosperous ideal family, after 2007, the patriarch of family was Lalit Chundawat. Nearly after decades, the family appeared very regular and an ideal Indian family with three generations living under one roof. After 2007, the patriarch of the family was changed to Lalit Chundawat, the youngest son of Bhopal Singh. He assumed the role after his father passed away in 2007. For neighbors, relatives and friends, the family was happy. They never noticed any major behavioral changes that might have led them to take this step. They might be considered an ideal family from far, but close up they had a lot of strange things going on. The figurehead of this incident, or the person which we will be focusing on, is Lalit Singh. The diary which was collected from the house mentioned Lalit a couple of times. It gave the impression that Lalit had taken the role of a father figure for the family. Digging into Lalit's past, he had been in an accident during his college years that had led to injuries on his brain. His friend Chandir Prakash Mehta recounts that Lalit couldn't take his exams due to the injuries he sustained. In senior year, he fell sick again and had to drop out of the college because of that. Another incident that shook Lalit's life was in 2004 when he was attacked by a colleague. He worked at a plywood shop when he was pushed under sheets of plywood and the shop was set on fire. People thought he died in the accident. Fortunately, he made calls and saved himself. But the impact of the incident was so grave that he stopped speaking. Many of his family members assumed that he lost his voice in the incident, which again was unlikely because his injuries weren't that deep because he was able to save himself on time. Then in 2007, Lalit's father Bhopal Singh passed away due to respiratory illness. This further exacerbated Lalit's mental state. A puja was conducted shortly called Garuda Purana Path for 10 days. It was in one of these prayer sessions that Lalit started chanting Om and everybody was shocked. Everyone assumingly said daddy has... One of their neighbors, Naresh Yadav, recounts that he asked Lalit how he gained his voice. He replied stating his father appeared in his dreams and advised him to pray. After this, he never mentioned his father again. After this incident, the prayers would happen every day for 30 minutes. The rivers recount them praying morning, afternoon and night for continuous 30 minutes. They even had seen Lalit praying in front of a tree or offering food to the animals. The kids used to say that during those prayer sessions, their grandfather visited them. They changed their lifestyle entirely. They stopped consuming alcohol and non-veg food. They grew prosperous and their business expanded from one shop to three. They also renovated their house during this time. Priyanka, one of the members of the family, was getting married soon, and they spent a lot of money on preparation. At this point, I view the family as a cult. The authority figure of the cult was Lalit. People followed his ideas and principles staunchly. However, it seemed like the marriage of Priyanka was hurtful to Lalit and his cult. Since Priyanka was about to leave, Lalit couldn't bear losing a member. His attitude became more reserved than before. He slept days and nights before the engagement. He cited health issues whenever someone confronted him and turned taciturn. That's how, 10 days after the engagement of Priyanka, the entire family committed suicide. Talking about cult, for a cult to become an actual cult, there needs to be the principle or the authority of the cult which demonstrates some powers which go against the nature of law. And when Lalit spoke after a year and started talking about God and started depicting some things which led them to prosperous life, I believe that most of them believed what Lalit said and followed Lalit's principles, even if they agreed or not, for the betterment of their family. And that's how this entire cult or the entire superstition, occultism, was born in the family. And I feel like Lalit was kind of tense because Priyanka was soon going to leave, and he was afraid that Priyanka might go out and tell people the secrets of this family. The book which was found mentioned a couple of times that whatever ritual they were doing, they are not supposed to tell people outside their house, or they are not supposed to talk to certain people. If they do so, they will have to go through a strict punishment. I guess that is the reason why the children never spoke to anyone. Even their own relatives did not have any idea of the situation whatsoever. So, The House of Secrets was released by Netflix and I watched it on Sunday. It is a 3-episode series ranging at 45 minutes. It includes a couple of interviews and stuff like that. And this is my takeaway from The House of Secrets. So the first thing is that the series raises an important question of our superstitious society. It leaves us with a moral. There's this particular dialogue in one of the episodes which says that there is a fine line between faith and delusion. We have to ask ourselves, are we crossing the line? The second one is the importance of mental health. I believe Lalit was mentally ill, and after the numerous incidents he went through, a doctor had recommended him to seek a psychiatrist. But he never visited one due to the stigma surrounding mental health in India. I believe if he would have sought help, the family would have been in a better state. It baffles me how the younger generation of the family that was quite educated never questioned the practices or the rituals dictated by Lalit. The diary mentioned a couple of times that the ritual should not be made fun of since it is the wish of Bhopal. But it makes me question whether or not the younger generation had doubts about the situation, or they were helpless, or maybe they were cooperative. Investigation, or what was the revelation of the investigation, and this caused a lot of public outrage because people believed that police were not doing their job properly when this was not the case. I believe that this incident and the way media covered it and the whole fiasco which happened was like a warning or a trailer of the further downfall of broadcast journalism in India. Like, after the incident lost its prime, none of the media reporters went back and created like an update or created some special investigation series on this situation. They only were there for the purpose of TRP, for the purpose of covering the news, and for the purpose of getting as much sensation as they could. Okay, there were few exceptions, like some of the reporters which are actually involved in the series, in documenting a series. They seemed like someone came from a more genuine perspective. So that's it for the video. I have covered almost all parts of the case, including the review of the Netflix series. I do have to give a fair warning that the series contains a couple of graphic information about the case, including the autopsy and how the case was done. You and there are a couple of sources which I have referred to. I'll put it in the bio, so you can go to my description and you can read those news articles to learn about the incident. That's it. Thank you.